This story is about embracing difference and not being afraid of being different or of being taken as a different person. When I went to Fiji from Argentina, the culture that I found was very different from what I had in Argentina in my own setting. So at the beginning, according to my dream, the missionary had to really try to be as much as she or he could like the people. So I tried to erase all the differences. And every time that somebody pointed out my different race or different language or different way of understanding life, I will take it as an offense, as something that I didn't really was doing well enough. But as I got more and more into the culture, I realized that it was impossible really to become in a short time exactly like the other people. And I worried about that. So how am I supposed to be a good missionary if I don't really become one of them? In the meantime, it happened that we had the World Youth Day in Australia. So a large group of Fijians, including myself, went to Australia. And they were so surprised by the way that other places developed the youth ministry, how they were organized. And they valued that. And they, when they came back, they wanted to do something like that. They appreciated what was different in other places, and they thought, well, we can learn from that. So they approached me and they said, okay, you are coming from those different places, so you must know what to do. And I said, yes, I know how to run a youth group back in Argentina, but I don't know if that will really work in this place. So I was tempted to say, no, forget it. I have to learn everything from you. You are the ones. I can't really teach you something from a different place. But anyway, they insisted and insisted. So I said, okay, why don't we, since I don't speak all the languages that you speak here, why don't you choose some of you, a smaller number, and you come with me, I present to you what I know, and you see what is good for you and what is not good. And you are the ones who go to your own groups, villages, and different parishes later, and you are the ones who put it forward to the others. So, okay, let's see how it works. And that's how we started. And it was an amazing process. We will always meet, and I will, well, prepare. First, I had to bring my materials from Spanish into English. And then in the meetings, I will share with them the different dynamics in English. They will translate it into their own different languages. And then we will go to each different village, and each one of them will be the ones who will call for the meetings and facilitate the processes. And for them, that was something absolutely different, because they were used to the teacher who will come and teach them everything, including the church, but they are kind of in a passive way. So this time, they were the ones delivering. And the reception from their peers was really amazing. So it was really a story of empowerment for the ones who were leading and for the ones who were receiving. And it was a very big lesson for me. Sometimes we try to erase differences, but actually that's the richness that our Catholic Church has. That's being Catholic, when we can include everybody and share our differences without being afraid of them, Because we can learn from the others and they can learn from us. If we are all the same, there is nothing to learn. Thank you.